Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to show you how to use the filter function in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
Here I have a spreadsheet of endangered species, what their population is, and the habitat in which you can find them. But what I would like to do is filter out my data over here in cell E2. So how would I go about doing that? Well, Excel has a built-in function called filter. So if I type equals filter with a left parenthesis, the first argument I am being asked for is what array of data do I wish to filter? So I'm just going to click on A2, keep my left mouse button down, and drag over here to the right and to the end of my data set, because that is my array of data. Now, if I type a comma, my next argument that I'm being prompted for is where is the data that I wish to filter? So let's say I would like to just see all the forest animals. So I'm going to highlight this range of cells where the habitat is listed. And then I'm going to type an equals sign, and I'm going to click in this cell here because I would like to return only the forest animals. So if I click there and then end my parentheses and press enter, you will see that only my forest animals are being displayed over here. Now, this is filtering data out of my data set based on one criterion. What if I wanted more than one?
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So I'm going to click back in E2 where my filter formula is, and I'm going to click here right after the comma to my include argument, and I'm just going to wrap this in parentheses from the beginning of my include argument to the end. Now, if I would like to do an and, like an additional criteria here, I would type a star after those parentheses. And then I'm going to begin another left parenthesis for a second set of criteria. So let's say in this case, I only want to return the forest animals that have a population of less than 10,000. So now, if I highlight my population just like I had highlighted my habitat, and I make that less than 10,000, and then close those parentheses and hit enter, I can now see that I'm only being returned with the forest habitat and the population less than 1,000. But let me show you one more criterion that you can enter. So I'm going to click back in E2, and I'm just going to highlight over what I had just put in with B2. And instead of having the population, let's also pick the habitat that has the savanna. So I'm going to highlight my habitat again, type equals, and scroll up here to any of the fields that say savanna. And then one last change. Instead of doing a star here, I'm going to backspace and put a plus. So what the plus does is it's kind of like an or. So think of it this way. I want this criteria and this criteria. So if I hit enter, I can see that I'm being returned with all forest animals and all savanna animals. So just remember, the plus is an or, the star is an and. I'm going to include the link to our blog below in the description, because in our blog, we have some more scenarios that you can use with the filter function that will help you expand on this idea that we've done in this video. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.